Welcome back. In keeping with our theme of the season, ending the year by doing good for others, we have brought back one of our favorite people. Nick Jordan is here from Wells of Life. And Nick, you were with us earlier in the year, and that was the first time we learned about Wells of Life, and you're building wells, freshwater wells in Uganda to bring fresh water to the villages that would not otherwise have it. But as a result of coming on the show earlier, you've had great developments since then. So we really wanted to hear from you again and let you share what's going on with Wells of Life.
Thanks, Lauren. It's wonderful to be back, and I really appreciated the tremendous warm welcome you gave me last time. So I really feel at home sitting on your couch, and
good.
I bring some wonderful good news and great tidings of success. And without any further ado, let me tell you what happened.
Please.
We had such an outpouring of, first of all, of interest in the work of Wells of Life, because the question of, you know, what can we do to be involved was asked. And of course, we were able to answer it by letting people know that it's very easy to support Wells of Life. We're a local nonprofit, and we simply engage people in the work of funding wells.
They're not expected to go dig them themselves.
No, we draw the line there. Okay. We actually can handle the digging part.
Okay.
It's the digging into the wallet part that the donor is most especially asked to help and do. But I'd love to give you some numbers, because I know there's lots of people watching, as many as 18,000 people.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what I can say is that there are 4,000 people in Uganda right now in four different communities that are actually drinking clean, potable water as a result of the show.
Wow.
What a number.
How did that happen?
Well, it happened very easily and simply. You have an incredible lady who's a makeup artist here, and you know, who helped my Irish nose not look so red. Her name is Constance, and she was moved and inspired, as were you. And she introduced me to her church. It's no more than a stone's throw from here. And as a result, her pastor, Pastor Leland, invited me to come and speak. And I got to come and speak to the congregation, not once, not twice, but actually on five occasions. It made for a wonderful weekend. And what happened was, there was a huge outpouring of support, and two wells were funded right on the spot, and that one day. But that wasn't it. The congregation really felt moved that with just a donation that was as small as even $10, they could profoundly affect the lives of one person or more. So they kept fundraising, and they kept that lighting, and a second and a third well were donated.
Wow.
So three wells in total, and only a month ago, a fourth well was donated.
From the same community.
From the same community.
That's amazing. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. It's lovely to be able to share such a story, because oftentimes we talk about the need. It's beautiful to be able to talk about the results that happen right here in our own community.
Yeah, and then I know you also have an opportunity for people to get involved in other ways. It's not straight up donations through their community. What else can they do with you guys?
We have a beautiful program that we call our Ambassador Program, and it's where everybody essentially could take a role such as Constance took and introduce Wells of Life to their family. It's a perfect gift coming up to Christmas. To give the gift of water is essentially the gift of life.
It is indeed.
Now, that works very simply by making a donation. We're a local-based Orange County nonprofit. We're here in Irvine. And so you can become a monthly giver starting with as little as $5. We have a website that all of that works through.
Okay.
But I would really love to have the opportunity to meet, you know, more of your viewers. I have met about 300 members of the Laguna Woods community from the introduction that this show gave me.
That's great.
And that's a lot of people with a lot of excited hearts. So, you know, coming up to Christmas, great invitation to be able to give the gift of water. Hang it on the tree, or put it under the tree, or just give it as a gift.
Or give an introduction.
Or give that introduction, because, you know, we both know that sometimes it's the introduction that really opens the door.
Right.
And that's what this show has done. It's opened the door that remains open right now And I have no idea what's going to happen, but I know it's going to be profound.
Yeah, I know it is. And that's why we wanted to have you back, because that kind of success and that kind of a story, we want to keep it going. But what inspires you? I know you brought some reading material that you that you look to for inspiration also. So maybe you want to share that with us.
Oh, I'd love to. Well, I'm an avid reader. I might have told you last time, I'm an old school teacher from Ireland, so you never quite lose that part of your of your life. And I read a couple of books a month. Well, back in 2008, when I was going to Uganda, a book was published. I just happened to bring a copy of it along because it's got a 10-year anniversary edition.
Oh, nice.
It's called The Hole in Our Gospel. And it's actually not a religious book. It really is a book that introduces how we can serve and how we can actually live our faith in a very profound way. It really addresses the reason why there's poverty and how we as individuals can actually play our part to help. So I read that book in 2008. It really colored my thinking, mm-hmm. especially when I went to Uganda. And as a result, Wells of Life has given away over 200 copies.
Oh, nice.
Really, we get letters all the time from our donors that have read this book that really become inspired to do more, mm-hmm. and, of course, to be more. So if anybody is looking for a wonderful read, you know, this Christmas or this, you know, season, here. I would strongly suggest that a copy of this will really inspire you in so many ways. And it's a terrific gift also.
Perfect.
And it's actually written by, yes, of course, I should just mm-hmm. tell you, it's written by the retired CEO of one of the largest Christian charities in the world, World Vision. Mm-hmm. His name is Rich Stearns. His story is well written and it's beautifully explained in the book.
Excellent. Well, I'm glad you're able to share this because, again, gifts come in every different shape, size. It doesn't really matter. Wherever we find the inspiration to that moves us for the holiday season, I think that's perfect. So we're going to give our viewers, of course, all the information on Wells of Life, the website, and however they can contact you. And we're going to hope that at this time of giving, you're going to be a recipient again.
Just to mention one simple thing, we all think of children, especially coming up to Christmas. There is nothing more beautiful than bringing just one child the gift of water this Christmas. And because this is what we do and we love to do it, we'd be more than happy to visit, meet with anybody that would like to learn more about Wells of Life. And I'm more than happy to do so.
Okay, Nick, thank you so much. We're so happy to continue to share your message.
Thank you, Lauren. Wonderful to be here.
And we'll be right back. Thank you.